Hey, what's poppin'? Are you ready? I'm sure you already have, but watch with me. The Benny Blanco BTS Snoop Dogg collaboration. I'm gonna be honest here, I have no idea, none, what to expect. First of all, this has been, as Twitter has said, the most unserious project in the history of major projects. We have major people here. We have producing of Benny Blanco, which I'll be honest, I'm really frustrated with ARMY. Not all ARMY, obviously, but you know, Benny Blanco did that 1 minute remix of, what was it? Like Love, Blood, Sweat, and Tears, and Life Goes On. That might not be quite right, I can't remember. But he was commissioned to do a 1 minute remix of the three songs, and there are ARMY who gave him so much crap for, they just didn't like it, and they felt like ARMY does better with That's because we have an incredible fandom that's super, super, super talented and super passionate. So of course we don't want people tainting that. Benny didn't taint anything. I thought it was fun. It was like a great 1 minute that's like very TikTokable. And anyway, off my rant about that. Ever since back in what spring, Snoop Dogg said in a radio interview that he'd heard of BTS and he would totally be down for a collaboration with them because making great music with unusual sources is exactly what he does. And then after the guys on the Grammy red carpet referenced Snoop Dogg as somebody they would want to collaborate with, and then in Vegas when they took a photo with Benny Blanco, like, and then Benny Blanco was like throwing a USB with the song, possibly video on it, possibly in the woods of LA, possibly just in his own backyard. We don't even, this whole thing has been bonkers. And the rap line's not even in this. We have Snoop Dogg and the vocal line. Like, make it make sense for me. Make it make sense for me. None of this makes any sense to me. And so I'm a little afraid. Can I just be honest? I'm afraid it's gonna suck. I don't know how this is gonna turn out, is what I'm trying to say. The positive thing is, I don't know a ton about Benny Blanco, except for he is talented. And I know enough about Snoop Dogg to know, I think he's brilliant, I think he's talented, and I don't think he puts his name on crap. And our men are talented and brilliant and do not put their name on crap. So, however, it's also just been like super unhyped, unpromoed. Or then again, maybe that's just because my life, my personal life is falling apart. I've been setting up my new life space. That maybe it is being really promoed and I just don't know, because I didn't even know who BTS was until like September and October of 2020. We're gonna do this now and it's gonna be super exciting. By the way, do you think BTS would be in this video? My answer is no. However, they did TikTok promotions for it, but they weren't here to film anything. And unless this has actually been in the works since they were here for Vegas, is Snoop Dogg gonna be in the, like, what? What is this? One way to find out. Let's do this. Thank you for watching with me.
Radio station.
Ha!
BTSNOOP.
No makeup on, I let it. You so damn beautiful, I swear you make me sick. I want your love, I want your name. Inside my heart there's nothing but a burning flame. Oh god, their voices. Come a little bit closer, don't make me wait. Let's make some bad decisions. Benny is just like us. Who was that? Was that a white? Who was that? I remember this from the TikTok thing. Ah! Everybody's looking fly. And I think I know the reason why. Yeah! Because I got you right here by my side. Oh! I can't let you just walk away. If I ain't with you, I'm not okay. I love this. Yeah. This is so cute. Oh my god. Let's make some bad decisions. I want you, baby, all of the time. By the way, ARMY is way nuttier than this about concerts, but this is pretty close. I love the song.
Let's do things you always wanted. Have some fun and live your life. Help me waste a day and find a place that we can face to face. Let me show you around my hood. It's bad meaning bad, like bad meaning good.
I love Snoop.
When it comes to rules, I break them.
I love the song. It's so good. It's so cute. Where is this? What stadium is that? What stadium is that?
I'm here for the BTS show.
You're a day early.
What do you mean I'm a day early?
Show's tomorrow.
No, man. Tonight.
Today is Saturday. This says Sunday. But I would get a new ticket if I were you.
No, man. You gotta let me wait here. I've been running all day. I don't even know where my car is. I left it in the middle of Sunset Boulevard.
Well, you're here 24 hours early.
What is this crazy video?
28 hours because you were 4 hours early at a show.
Okay, yeah.
Wait here for 28 hours, then just go home.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I really would. I'll have the best seat in the house.
Okay. Well.
Tickets don't work that way.
So it's not like you're waiting for the best. Seat
house, that's
right. You know BTS.
I've heard of BTS.
Okay. Sure. Okay. Name me one BTS song.
Dynamite.
My son does that.
You're gonna make me just sit out here. Really?
Benny is so unserious. Oh my god, I'm sorry, I'm yelling. I'm such a yeller. No, I want more.
I'm broke.
Ooh.
I want more. I want more. Okay, I want more. So the reason I got super emotional is because it's too friggin' cute. I'm emotional because, one, I get emotional. But BTS has helped me find who I am and, like, reclaim that. Which is easy to lose and can be very hard to find again. Anyhow, that's the way being at a BTS concert feels. That's how getting ready for a BTS concert feels. Having been able to do that with Peaches and my sister, and then do that with Laurie in both LA and Vegas respectively. The difference is like you have your outfit picked out, even like if your outfit's like totally chill, you have, or totally crazy, either which way, you have your outfit picked out days in advance and you're trying to get ready and feel good about how you look with like an air of cool about you, even though you do not feel even an ounce of chill in your soul because you're excited and you are smitten and obsessed to a capacity. Sorry if you can hear my washing machine over here. You feel absolutely overwhelmed trying to have that ounce of chill in you while being totally in love with BTS and with ARMY, with all seven men, with all millions of people who understand being in love with these seven men. And and as where Benny was making his poster to take to the concert, making those last minute touches and poor cake cuts. Sorry I yelled so much. I'm home alone and I have the freedom to just like be excited and be myself right now. On top of that, you know, what I experienced in both LA and Vegas that I would like to do better for the next concert is I was like my little gifts to make for ARMY. I was in the hotel room trying to sign them last minute and put them in bags and get them ready when frankly I wish I had gone to those cities with my gifts ready and in stow the way that a lot of other ARMY did. I don't know if anybody else was procrastinating and last minuting it in their hotel room the way that I was. Thankfully, Peaches, my sister, and Laurie were all very patient with me as I was battling sinus infections and getting my gifts ready. When, like, next time I just hope to be with you and just vibing. I think Benny is an actual ARMY. I know we as ARMY have a hard time trusting. We trust almost no one because people ride BTS for clout and then turn around and say really nasty things about them. So I'm bummed that BTS isn't actually in the video, as in they didn't record any video aspects. The song though, I love, and I totally get the vocal line part here. And then Snoop is so fun and so laid back. I was a teen in the 90s when our beautiful Bangtan men were born. Snoop was coming into, he was breaking through. He was part of that group of, you know, the Warren G and Snoop and Dre and Ice Cube, who were breaking down a lot of walls, barriers, stereotypes, and they were singing their truth at the time. They were young men singing the truth of their realities and their struggles and their pressures that society at large was ignorant to, purposefully ignorant to, and or just made a mockery of. Snoop was, what was he? Was he like 19 at the time when he came? Am I wrong on that? Anyway, he was a child, basically, a young man who was part of a tribe of men who were pioneering, speaking honest truths through their music, reshaping what the landscape of music looked like, reshaping what telling the truth of American landscape looked like, of what being an American, what being a Black American, what being a Black American in a city, what pressures, what scrutiny, like, his music was fun, but it also tapped into just singing an honesty of their life story. Do you get what I'm saying here? I'm making the parallel between Snoop and what BTS's mission was when they came on the scene. And now both groups, you know, Snoop isn't a group, but you know what I mean. Both sets of men, all the men, not groups, all the men now are at a point where they can sing the heavy hitting songs when they want and need, but it's different because their struggle is different now. And they can also just make genuinely fun, laid back vibes and bops that are unserious. And Benny is the man for that. That was a lot of rambling. I'm excited. Did any of that make any sense? I don't even know if I'm coherent. Let's rewatch this because that was awesome. I did not watch this when it premiered. I immediately set up, as I do, on Spotify. I found a playlist where an amazing ARMY at midnight dropped a playlist and had it bad decisions oriented with some Yet to Come and Left and Right and Hobie's whole album. I mean, you know, we've got that. Like, we have had so much music that we're trying to focus on this year. This is really hard to do. I don't know how we're supposed to do this. But anyhow, I had one phone set up with Spotify and the other phone set up with Apple Music with headphones on so that I couldn't hear the song or see the video until I could sit down and watch it with you. Thank you for watching this video with me. Thank you for taking the time to watch with other people here who love BTS and letting me watch with you. I appreciate that. The lyrics are so cute. Okay, this time I am gonna turn on the translation, the subtitles, which is crazy because this is all in English, right? So I didn't hear any Korean. This was all in English, correct? I was so caught up in how cute the video was and how beautiful the men's voices were in certain lines that really did catch my ear and eyes. Let's do this again.
Radio station BT.
My new room. My new room. You'll see it.
No makeup on. I let it. You're so damn beautiful. You make me sick.
That's such a Gen Z thing to say.
Inside my heart, there's nothing but a burning flame.
Oh my god, it's so cute. Please. Benny is so unserious. I love him. I will. Who is that? Who's helping him make the cake? Oh, I love the vocal line. can fly. That's a very Lizzo vibe. She has one of her songs, right? Which one? Reminds me of a Lizzo song. What song was that? I do. Okay. I won't. Benny is so cute. Who is this woman? I want to know who she is. Why is he biting bubble wrap? Oh, their voices are so sweet.
Wanted. Have some fun and live your life. Help me waste a day and find a place that we can face to face. Let me show you around my hood. Is bad meaning bad, like bad meaning good.
Yeah.
When it comes to rules, I break them. Let's make some
bad decisions. Sorry, you don't need my voice. What does that shirt say? Whoa. Wait, I didn't notice the shirt. That's French. That's French and why? I see the year 2019 and 2020, right? I know a little French, not much. Like, I want to say that's the liqueur, but I'm like, as in heart, I'm pretty sure it's not though. Is that an R? C-O-U-R, liqueur de 24th. Somebody, Army, you're smart. Please tell me one of you understands. Delilah, and also, am I saying your name right? Delilah, I love you. If I'm blessed enough that you happen to be watching this video, if I'm saying your name wrong, please correct me. I love your name. D-I-L-A-Y-L-A. You leave comments sometimes. Your last comment, I will talk to you about this later. Literally, I collapsed in my floor and cried. I collapsed in my kitchen floor when I read it and sobbed because it meant so much to me. That's for another time. But first off, my daughter's name is Layla. So I always end up pronouncing it Delilah, and if I'm saying it wrong, please forgive me. You are French. You are in France. Can you please let me know? 24th of, does that say June? Does that say January? Am I making this up? 2019? There's a meaning to this, because, and what is it with BTS and ARMY and our pearl necklaces? I've like a whole other tangent here. I've never been into pearls until seeing the guys wear their fun pearl. Anyway, and then my Bangtan bestie sister made me the most beautiful pearl Bangtan. I need to know what the shirt says. All right, let's go back to poor Benny hitting the brakes. I love California. I love a lot. I'm so excited right now. Let's make some bad decisions. I want you. Put the chick in his mouth. Poor dude. Oh, your kisses. Oh, I will. I love Benny. Seriously, this is, yeah, empty stadium. What stadium is this? Because that's not SoFi.
I'm here for the BTS show.
Is that... Is that San Diego's?
The show's tomorrow.
No, man. It's tonight. Look.
Look at his. Look at that cute Saturday, heart poster.
This says Sunday. And I would get
I don't care about the scene. Hold on.
Sunday.
Look at that. Oh my God. He has like all the butter. I really wish I could scroll up and zoom in. Those are all cutouts from the butter promos. Look at Hobie's butter yellow hair and pink June after June swore he wouldn't go pink again. Got Rainbow Jimin, Lollipop Tay. If you were in Vegas for, what was that, night two? Tay was a danger to society that night. I just need to say that. Oh my God, look how cute they are. Anyhow, for the last couple of days, I haven't been able to get to this area of the room, and I've been trying to set up my new bedroom, but I didn't want to do anything until I could come here for bad decisions and to talk about Hobie and Hobie Palooza and to watch the vlogs together. So please look forward to that. What do you think about the song? I feel like you have to think it's fun. However, I felt like everybody would feel that way about... I thought everybody would feel that way about Permission to Dance. If Permission to Dance were half in Korean, I wonder if fans who didn't like it would have been horrible about it still. Really, people kept talking about how... Sorry, I'm not going to delve into something sucky and serious for long here, but people kept delving into... how BTS lost their way, the people who wanted to hate on it. But the only thing they had to say is, they're doing these American songs now. And people did say they liked their harder stuff, in which case, they still make hard stuff. I don't know. I don't understand people's beef with fun things. Why everything has to be heavy. Life is heavy enough. Sometimes it can just be fun. It can just be a bop. That's my stance on it. I hope you're having a good weekend. I hope that you are enjoying the song. I hope you've been enjoying the video. I hope that it made you yell and giggle at parts too. Things that lighten and lift right now. Things that are serious are also good too, because we know we're in it together. But it's also so important to laugh together and to have a good time. God loves you. I love you. BTS loves you. Love yourself and any way you can, especially when it's hard, and know that we're in this together. You never walk alone. Let's make some bad decisions. Let's make some good bad decisions. Like Snoop said, bad in the good way. Oh my God, I'm liking this song more and more right now already. Okay, I'll talk to you next time. Bye.